Hi, good evening to all. Today we are going to look at an important topic of organizational behavior. So today's topic is the measures adopted to increase the group cohesiveness or the factors which influence in the group cohesiveness. Before the starting the session, we will look at the meaning of the group cohesiveness. This definition is given by Stephen Robbins. According to him, the group cohesiveness is the degree to which members are attracted to each other and are motivated to stay in the group. In short, the group cohesiveness means the degree of the uniqueness among members. They should be attracted to each other and motivated themselves to be in the group. There are some factors which are adapted to increase group cohesiveness. These are, the first factor is similarities of attitudes and values which fueled the group cohesiveness. People enjoy the company of people who hold similar opinions, morals, beliefs and a code of conduct, because the person who shares the same opinions as we do provide the as with a kind of a social validation for our beliefs, which means if members have the same kind of opinions, morals and beliefs, they will share anything with the group members easily and understandable way, through which the group cohesiveness will increase. The next factor is size of the group. Small groups are effective as there will be high degree of interaction and communication with each other. If the group size is very small or in medium, there is a possibility of interaction and communication will be more, through which the group cohesiveness will be more. The next factor is the time. It is quite natural that the more time people spend with one another, there is more tendency that they do get closer to each other, thus strengthening the degree of cohesiveness. If a group of members spend a lot of time with one another, there is a possibility of closenesses to each other in the group, through which the group cohesiveness will be fueled. The next factor is location, where members of a group are located close together, separated from other groups, they will develop greater cohesiveness because of constant face-to-face interaction. If members are situated very close to each other, there is a lot of possibility of interaction continuously, through which the group cohesiveness will be more. The next factor is status. A high status group receives greater loyalty from its members, which in turn makes the group stronger. High status group has a greater loyalty in the society, through which the group cohesiveness will be increased. The next factor is the difficulty in entry. The more difficult is it to get in a group, the more cohesive that the group becomes. The more exclusive the group, the more is the cohesiveness among members. The external individual cannot enter into the group because there is group cohesiveness into the group, which is assumed as there is more group cohesiveness exists in the group. The next factor is interdependency. Which members are doing the operations which are dependent upon each other. Mutual dependence leads to greater cohesiveness. It mainly depends on the operations of the members. They are not specialized on specific place, so they are then dependent to each other, through which then the group cohesiveness will be increased. Management behavior: the manager can make close relations difficult by creating unhealthy competition among employees. On the other hand, he can fuel the solidarity by rewarding cooperative behavior. The manager or leader in the group, he will motivate the members to be more group cohesiveness. For that, he will provide, he will reward the group members continuously. He sometimes maybe encourage the group cohesiveness, but sometimes he does not. But the manager will influence the group cohesiveness now in the group. The next factor is threat. It is a very powerful force which unifies the group, particularly when it comes from outside the group. Cooperation can help over some threat. There is little or no chance for escape. If a manager threats the members to perform a specific job, the group members will cohesive with each other to complete that performance, complete that task, through which the group cohesiveness will be built in greater extent. The next factor is the previous successes and the shared goals. When a group achieves a meaningful goal, the cohesiveness of the group increases because the success is shared by all the members and each one feels responsible for the achievement. The group achieved them previously in greater manner to be kept it in same success in future periods they will be more group cohesiveness. Because they will feel more responsible for that success. To keep that success they will be more cohesiveness occur in the group. The next factor is cooperation. More cooperative, helpful and understanding the group members are, there is more cohesiveness. It is not only applicable in the organization, in the personal life also. If the members in the group in a helpful mind and the cooperative manner, the group cohesiveness will be more. Thank you. We will see you again with another session. Until then, stay tuned, stay blessed. Bye.